Hi, my name's David. I'm one of the discovery staff in Ontario Parks. And in particular, I'm here at Presqu'ile Provincial Park, where I'm standing on our 3 kilometer sandy beach. Now, when you think of a beach, most people think of a place where you can go swim and build sandcastles and play and just lie in the sun. And that's certainly true, and that's what we offer here at Presqu'ile. But beaches are also important for wildlife. And in particular here, they're important for a type of bird called a shorebird. Now these are the sandpipers and the plovers, and they all nest in the Arctic, and they fly south in the fall, and fall for shorebirds starts in late July, and they fly all the way down, some of them to the tip of South America. So that's a migration of thousands and thousands of kilometers, and they can't do that all in one go. They need places to stop and rest and feed, and Presqu'ile is one of the places where they like to do that. So as a park, we recognize that, and what we do is we try to manage our beach to give a balance between what people need and want and what shorebirds need. And we do that by raking the beach in different ways through the year and at different sections. So if you came here to go swimming, you would go down to beach 1 and 2, and we rake that every day, and we get rid of the algae on the shore, and it's a great place to play. Up at this end of the beach, we don't rake it as often, maybe once or twice a week. We let that algae accumulate on the shore. Now, algae is an icky green thing. People don't like to step in it, but it's full of invertebrates, and that's what the shorebirds need to eat. So we manage that. We also block off a section of the beach throughout the whole year, so they always have a place to go where they're not disturbed. So in this way, our beach here is for both people and wildlife. Now, through the years, we've had about 41 species of shorebirds stop here. In any one year, we have 20, 25 different types, and I'd like to show you some of those.
So this is a little semi-palmated plover, a very, very typical-looking plover, a fairly chunky, short, stubby bill, and they have a very distinctive feeding. They sort of step and peck, step and peck. These pretty little shorebirds are short-billed dowitchers, even though their bills are quite long. And they're a medium-sized shorebird, and they feed in the algae with that rather frantic sewing machine motion. Shorebird migration also occurs in the spring, and here we have some ruddy turnstones in their beautiful spring plumage. They're feeding on the beach, and they're flipping things over to find food. And they're flipping over the material that the winter has accumulated on the beach. And we don't clean our beach, we don't rake our beach until after migration is over in mid-June.
So those are some of the shorebirds we have here, and I hope you think they're as interesting and fascinating as I do. They're all a little bit different, they're all very, very interesting, and I hope you appreciate that we need to give them space on our beaches and make sure that they always have a place to rest on their long, long migration.